Hi, hello everyone. This is Kriba from second year BTech IT of SNS College of Technology. Today I am here to share some things about artificial intelligence with Python. Yeah, we know something about artificial intelligence. Now, artificial intelligence is becoming an hottest field in computer science due to its development, and Python is the easiest language we are using nowadays. So today we are going to see both artificial intelligence and Python and how these both are working together. Okay, first let I explain what is artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is the capacity given by us, that is by humans, to machines to think, to create, then to create from experience, to remember from experience, to learn from experience, and to make decisions by their own. This is called artificial intelligence. The history of artificial intelligence was planted by the classical philosophers. It was beginning in antiquity with myths, with stories, with rumors, which endowed with intelligence. If we think, okay, for an example, if I feel sweating, then I have to go and put on the switch. But if the fan feels, oh, she is sweating, like that, it feels by itself and it starts rotating, then that is the modern artificial intelligence. The humans are now trying to do that one. So the father of AI is John McCarthy. He coined a new phrase for artificial intelligence. He could probably use computational intelligence. He is not just the father of AI, he is also the inventor of Lisp. Okay, let me see an interesting thing in artificial intelligence. The artificial intelligence first invention, that is first intelligence robot, that is called Shaki. Shaki was developed at SRI International from 1966 to 1972. Shaggy is the first AI-based mobile robot to accomplish a task without the need for step-by-step instructions. Whatever we now see is the first artificial intelligence robot, Shaggy. Now we are going to see about the latest artificial intelligence robot, Sophia. Sophia is the second humanoid robot which was developed by Hong Kong-based company Hansen Robotics. Yes, we see some things about artificial intelligence and its basic knowledge now we get. Okay, now we enter into the Python. Python is a general purpose language. It was first developed on 1990. The term general purpose means it can be used by all type of users and all the applications. Then it is a most popular programming language. So it can be used by all the users worldwide. Then it was created by Guido van Rossum and it was first released on February 20, 1991. Then now we are going to see how this Python is used in artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence with Python. Python has surfaced as the dominant language in AI/ML programming because of its simplicity and flexibility, as well as its great support for open source libraries such as Scikit-learn, Keras, SPSI, and TensorFlow. From this graph, we can understand that Python is the major code language for AI and ML because its rate becoming increase and increase by years. Why Python is good for AI/ML? A great library ecosystem, a low entry barrier, flexibility, platform independence, readability, good visualization options, community support, growing popularity. These are the 8 major reasons why Python is good for AI/ML. Yes, the 8 points, what the 8 points now we see is the 8 major reasons why Python is good for AI and ML. The great library ecosystem. Yes, it is the most important point for why Python is the most popular programming language for AI. The Python library is a model, a group of models which provide different sources like PyPy, which include pre-written piece of code. It can be given base codes to the developers. So the developers don't have to write the code from very beginning at every time. Okay, let me see the second point, low entry barrier. Low entry barrier allows the data scientist to pick up the Python very easily without wasting their time in studying the language. So Python is the everyday English commands. So it is very easy to work, and its simple syntax allows the users to make huge problems with simple methods. Okay, let me see the third point, flexibility. Flexibility is the major choice why we choose Python for machine learning. Yes, in Python there is two either or choice, like we can use OOPs or scripting language. Then in Python the programmers can make any changes at any time and they can get the results quickly. The fourth one is platform independent. Not only Python is easy to work and easy to learn, but also versatile. So it saves time and money for tests on various platforms and makes the overall process more simple and convenient by using the platforms like Windows, Mac, OS, Linux, Unix, and 21 other users. The fifth reason is readability. Python is easy to read, so the data scientists can easily debug the error and they can make the changes easily and quickly. Then the sixth point is good visualization options. By using Matplotlib in Python, the data scientists can easily build the histograms, charts, and they can give the clear reports by using that. The seventh reason is community support. Python is easily available on online. Anyone with online can get access with Python easily because Python is an open source language. Then the eighth reason is growing popularity. Nowadays, Python is becoming more and more popular among data scientists and artificial intelligence. So these are the eight reasons happening in Python, why Python is good for AL and ML. Okay, I think I'm done with that. Thank you for patient listening. Thank you.